हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. डियर फ्रेंड्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस विच इज़ क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स. एंड इन दैट क्लास वी डिस्कस ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट, ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज टेक एंड सॉल्व इन प्रीवियस क्लासेस. ओके, नाउ इन दैट क्लास वी ऑल्सो टेक एंड डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट थ्योरम्स रिलेटेड टू दैट चैप्टर एंड वी टेक and solve some important questions based on that theorems. Okay, so let us take we discuss about a very important theorem of your NCERT exercise, and theorem is the line segment joining the midpoints joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle, any two sides of a triangle is parallel to third is parallel to third side and is parallel to third side and equal to half of it and equal to half of it. Listen, this is one of the most important theorem of your syllabus. Okay, so dear student, this is one of the most important theorem related to the chapter quadrilaterals. Your question is, the theorem is the line segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to third side and equal to half of it. This is also called the midpoint theorem related to that topic, which is very important for you and your upcoming examination. So let us take its proof. So first of all, we draw a triangle. Let's see. We draw a triangle ABC. So first of all, writing given we can write a triangle ABC. A triangle ABC in which, let us take the midpoint of AB and AC is R, B and E. Let us, in which D and E are the midpoints of sides AB and AC respectively. Okay, so let us take so we have to show that then the line segment joining the midpoint. So we join D. So we have to show that. What? To prove. We have to prove. What we prove? We have to show that D parallel to BC and that line segment equal to half of it. Means half of BC. Okay. To prove, first is what? D parallel to BC. And second thing is that what? D is equal to half of BC. Okay, because we have to show that if the line segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is parallel to third side and equal to half of it. Okay, so this is one of the most important theorem related to that topic. Okay, now in proving that theorem we have to do some construction, and we construct what? We just produce D to F and join CF and join GF. So we have to write construction. In construction we join DE and produce to F and join CF. Okay, join CF. So this is a very important construction related to that theorem. Now we write its proof. we write it proof.
Let's see. Yes, so in proving that theorem, first of all, we have to show that DBCF is a parallelogram. So for parallelogram, what I do? If we have to show that DF parallel to BC and if we have to show that opposite sides parallel and equal, then the collator DBCF is a what? Parallelogram. Then we proved our result. So let's see.
So first of all, dear friends, we take triangle AED and triangle CEF. Now we take triangle AED, and triangle CEF. We have. Let's see. So in construction, we produce DE to F in such that and join CF. We produce to F such that DE is equal to EF. Okay,
DE is equal to EF.
In construction, DE produce to F such that DE is equal to
FE. Okay,
this is in construction and join CF. Okay, now in that triangle we have what? You know that, dear friends, this is equal to this. Okay, DE is equal to FE. This is by construction, by construction, and AE is equal to CE, and that angle means angle AED is equal to angle CEF. This is what? Vertically opposite angles. We know that vertically opposite angles are equal to each other. Okay, dear students. Now, and also A is equal to C. A is equal to CE. A is equal to CE because of E is the midpoint of AC. You have right here, since E is the midpoint of AC. So in this way, AE is equal to CE. Thus, by angle side angle. Side angle rule, congruence rule, triangle AED is congruence to triangle CEF. Triangle AED is congruence to triangle what? CEF. Thus by CPCT we get, means corresponding part of congruent triangle must be equal to each other. So by CPCT, dear friends, let's see what I get. We get as what? AD is equal to, now let's see, AD is equal to CF. AD is equal to what? CF. AD is equal to CF. We take equation number 1.
AD is equal to CF.
AD is equal to CF.
So let us take AD is equal to CF, and also angle ADE
is equal to angle CFE. Let's see, CFE. We take equation number 2.
So by using by CPCT, we find two results. AD is equal to CF, and as well as AD is equal to angle ADE is equal to angle, means angle AD is equal to angle CFE.
ओके नाउ लेट्स सी नाउ डियर फ्रेंड लेट्स सी तो सिंस AD is equal to DB, AD is equal to DB and as well as AD is equal to CF from F, from 1, from equation 1. Thus, we get what? CF is equal to DB. CF is equal to, means CF is equal to DB, okay? That is CF is equal to, yeah, DB is equal to CF. Take equation number 3. So, in that quadrilateral DBCF, we have to show that DB is equal to CF. Okay? Now, from 2, let's see, that angle is equal to that angle. So, we have to show, it is clear that that line segment parallel to that because of these are the alternate interior angle. Since from 2 we have angle ADE is equal to angle CFE. This is the alternate interior angle because of AD parallel to CF because of DEF is a straight line. DEF is a straight line. Okay, that is alternate interior angle are equal. So we have to show the AD as AB or DB parallel to CF. Means AD parallel to CF, or we have to show that because of AD is equal to DB, so DB also parallel to CF. We take equation number 4. So in this way, we have to show that DB is equal to CF and DB parallel to CF. Thus by equation 3 and 4, we can say that DB CF is a what? Parallelogram. Because of in parallelogram, if we have to show that opposite sides are equal and parallel, then we can say that the quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So here DBCF is a parallelogram. If DBCF is a parallelogram, so we can write DF parallel to BC, or we can write DE parallel to BC, and this is DEF. All points are collinear. Here the point DEF are collinear, na? And DEF are collinear. Thus, since DEF are collinear, that is DE is equal to FE. So in parallelogram, let's see opposite sides and parallel as well as equal. So BC is equal to DF. That is BC. We write as DF is equal to BC, and DF is equal to 2 times D. We can write 2 times D is equal to BC. Thus D is equal to half of BC. D is equal to half of BC. Hence proof. Thus demonstrated in this way. We can say that if the line segment joining any two points, of the midpoints of any triangle, then that line segments parallel to third side and equal to half of it. So this is one of the most important result related to the topic quadrilateral, chapter quadrilateral. So please, dear students, this is very important theorem. So please, dear students, do more and more practices of that theorem. And now, dear students, we take and solve some important questions based on that theorem. Let's see.
Now we take
and solve some important question related to that topic. And your question is if D E and F are respectively the midpoints, respectively the midpoints of sides BC BC CA and AB of an AB of an equilateral triangle ABC.
Okay, equilateral triangle ABC. Okay, dear students.
Prove that DEF is also an equilateral triangle.
Okay, now so first of all we draw the figure according to that question. After that we have to show that question. Okay, let's see its solution.
Now let's see, here first of all we draw a triangle ABC. Okay, let's see. So first of all we draw triangle ABC. Okay, and DEF are the mid, respectively the midpoints of side BC. D is the midpoint of side BC, E is the midpoint of side CA, and F is the midpoint of side AB. Here ABC is an equilateral triangle. Now we join just DEF, and we have to show that DEF is an equilateral triangle. Okay, now let's see its proof. Here this is given. Okay, this is given. Given here ABC is an equilateral triangle, and here DEF are the midpoints of the respectively side BC, CA, and AB respectively, and we have to show that DEF is also an equilateral triangle. This is a very important question. So let's see, dear friends. So first of all, in that question, since we know that we just proved a very important theorem. So since we know that, we write in this way. We know that the line segment joining the midpoint. Joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle is half of the third side. We know that
डियर स्टूडेंट वी नो दैट ना दैट रिजल्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू थ्योरम कि वी नो दैट डियर स्टूडेंट द लाइन सेगमेंट ज्वाइनिंग द मिड पॉइंट्स ऑफ टू साइड्स ऑफ अ ट्राइंगल इज हाफ ऑफ द थर्ड साइड. तो लेट अस टेक हेयर इफ यू टेक डी ई डी एंड ई हेयर डी इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ साइड बी सी and E is the mid point of side AC of the triangle ABC, then that line segment equal to half of the third side means half of AB. So since distance from figure D and E now to distance now from figure since from figure D and E D and A are the midpoints of the sides BC and CA respectively BC and CA respectively, then the line segment joining the midpoints of any side, two sides of a triangle ABC is always equal to half of it, third sides, according to theorem. So, dear friend, that is the line segment D is equal to half of its third side, half of its third sides. Similarly, dear friends, similarly, dear friends, E and F are the midpoints of the line segment AC and AB of the triangle ABC, then EF is equal to half of BC. Similarly, EF is equal to half of its third side means BC. Take equation number 2 and let's see now D and F are the midpoints of side BC and AB respectively. F and D are the midpoint of the sides AB and BC respectively. Then the line segment joining these midpoint FD or DF is equal to half of its third side means AC. Means DF is equal to what? Half of AC. Take equation number 3. Okay. So, dear students, in this way, according to theorem, we find that a very important relation DE is equal to what? Half of AB. EF is equal to half of BC. And DF is equal to half of AC, which is very important relationship. According to that figure, because of the assumption in proving that questions, first of all, you write that result. Okay, we know that if the line segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle, is half of the third side. So, according to that theorem, we get the result D is equal to half of AB, EF is equal to half of BC, and DF is equal to half of AC. Now, let's see. Now, since let's see, ABC is an equilateral triangle, and you know that in equilateral triangle all sides are equal to each other. So since ABC is an equilateral triangle, that is
ए बी इज इक्वल टू दैट इज ए बी इज इक्वल टू बी सी इज इक्वल टू व्हाट सी ए
दैट इज ए बी इज इक्वल टू बी सी इज इक्वल टू सी ए दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिलेशन ना इन एनी equilateral triangle because of you know that in any equilateral triangle all sides are equal to each other so according to that concept we have according to questions it is given that ABC is an equilateral triangle so dear friend if ABC is an equilateral triangle then the side its all sides are equal means AB is equal to BC is equal to CA respective now we divided by 2 now
we divided by 2 we get if we divided by 2 we get what half of AB is equal to half of BC is equal to half of CA now using equation 1, 2, and 3, we get. Dear friend, half of AB means what? We can write DE. Half of BC, we can write EF. And half of CA or AC, we can write DF. Okay? Now, thus
look at this result so in this way we have to show that ki
DE is equal to EF is equal to DF so in triangle DEF all of its sides are equal to each other means DE is equal to EF is equal to DF thus we can say that the triangle DEF is an equilateral triangle. Hence proof.
That result. So dear student, this is the method to prove that type of questions. Okay, dear student, let's see once more time. Because this is one of the most important question of your syllabus. In that question, dear student, we have an equilateral triangle ABC. And in that question, we have D, E, F are the midpoints of the sides BC, CA and AB respectively. And we have to show that D, E, F is also an equilateral triangle. So, in proving that theorem, first of all, we join D, E, F. Okay. Now, we write a very important result related to that topic. The line segment joining the midpoints of any two sides of a triangle is always half of its third side. So that statements mentioned in that type of questions. After that, we observe that triangle. So we get D and E are the midpoints of BC and AC, CA respectively. Then the line segment joining that two midpoints is DE is equal to half of AB. Half of AB, na? Similarly, EF is equal to half of BC and DF is equal to half of CA. Now, ABC is an equilateral triangle, so all of its sides are equal to each other. Now, we divided by 2. So, we write AB by 2, BC by 2 and CA by 2. And according to the equation 1 and 2, we have D is equal to half of AB. So, we can write DE is equal to EF is equal to DF. So, all of its sides are equal. If all sides are equal to each other, then we can say that the required triangle is what? Is an equilateral triangle. So this is the process to solve that type of question. So please, dear friends, do more and more practices of that type of questions based on midpoint theorem. After that, you can solve each and every question of your NCERT exercise based on that topic. So, okay, now in next class, dear friends, we take and solve some other important questions related to that topic. Okay, dear friends. Okay, dear friends. Now, in next class, we take and solve some other important question of your chapter. Okay, now thanks to all.